హలో
సార్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఓ2 మాలిక్యూల్ టుడే
ఓ2 మాలిక్యూల్ రైట్ డబుల్ బాండ్స్ ఓ2 మాలిక్యూల్ లెట్స్ సీ ద ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఓ2 కమ్ ఆన్ Formation of the molecule. Take the diagram back, come on. Two oxygen atoms you have to draw. Show this. See how double bond is formed between two oxygen atoms. Take the diagrams. So I'm making a gap because X is carrying a pair of electrons, Y is carrying a single electron, Z is carrying a single electron, and then we interrupt the action of Z here. Come on. This is called a PX. What PY? Any diagram you have to draw using hybridization. In many situations, you have to draw the diagrams, draw the neat diagrams. Even if this is again P diag, PX, PY, B and B are forming sigma, B and B are forming phi, forming phi one. Then we draw this sigma bond formation. B and B are. These are the overlapping components of the sigma. And extra, anyhow, not involved in bonding, you're getting a pair of electrons on the extra and as it is. 5 points. So, calculate the other 5 points. Sigma 5. Sigma 5. Oxidum. Oxidum. The molecule are four double bond O. Four double bond O. Back carefully. The diagram required compulsory. Completed?
Yes, sir.
All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. The electronic configuration of oxygen energy is 1s2, 2s2, 2px, 2py, 2pz. Two electrons, one electron, one electron, 2p4. In the formation of oxygen molecule, pz orbital of one of the oxygen atoms, water with pz orbital of other, result in the formation of sigma. Still, even py orbital carrying single electron. By parallel overlapping, within the formation of about 5 bond. So, oxygen molecule carrying a double bond, 1 sigma, 1 pi, that's enough, right? Right, first point. The electronic configuration of oxygen atom is, one s2, two s2, two px2, two py2, two py1, two z1. Next point. The formation of water molecule, the pz orbital of one of the oxygen atom, overlaps with pz orbital of other oxygen atom. Results in the formation of sigma bond. Next. Still remaining still remaining. Single electron carrying p y orbital. Single electron carrying p y orbital by parallel overlapping. Results in the formation of pi bond. Next, O2 molecule carry double bond 1 sigma 1 pi. Double bond 1 sigma 1 pi. Right, next. Triple bond. Example. Formation of N2 molecule. Come on.
All the three are getting single electron.
Come on, this is what px, py, pz. All carrying single electrons. Again, this one, px, py, pz. Z. Carefully take it. All are carrying single electron. This is what a PY. PZ. This one. Like sigma pi at pi. Take it. Into molecule. Other diagrams carefully. N triple bond N. Into molecule. Take it. Here we are, PX, PY, PZ, overlapping also, carefully do it. Thank you. Completed?
Yes.
So cool. 1 minute.
Right. Take 2 minutes time. Come on, complete. Right. Take it. With the board. Electronic computers now manual anatomy 1s2, 2s2, 2p x1, 2p y1, 2p z1. The formation of N2 molecule. 2p z orbital of one of the lateral atom bore like the 2p z orbital of other written in the formation of sigma. State the p y and p z which are carrying single electron by panel overlapping. Result in the formation of 2 pi bonds. In the formation of 2 pi bonds, the N2 molecule carry a triple bond, 1 sigma, 2 pi bonds. Come on. The electronic configuration of N atom is, electronic configuration of nitrogen atom is, right, 1s2, 2s2, 2p x1, y1, z1. Next, the formation of N2 molecule, next point, point wise, next point. The formation of N2 molecule, the 2p x orbital of one of the nitrogen atom, 2p x orbital, 2p x orbital of one of the nitrogen atom overlaps with. Overlaps with 2p x orbital of other nitrogen atom. Results in the formation of sigma bond. Leave it. Next point. The still remaining single electron carrying 2PY and 2PZ, 2PY and 2PZ by parallel overlapping. Results in the formation of two pi bonds. Next, N2 molecule carrying triple bond. 1 sigma, 2 pi bonds. Now let us go to the next concept. That is Pajan's rules. Pajan's rules, Pajan's concept. Right? Pajan's concept. Concentrate more, otherwise you're not easy to follow this one. Pajan's concept. Pajan's concept. To explain partial covalent character of ionic compound. To explain partial, look about partial ionic character. Partial ionic. Otherwise, I can say partial covalent character. Partial covalent character of the ionic compound. Ionic compound. Further, I propose the concept. To explain partial covalent character of ionic compound, Pajan has proposed a concept what we call Pajan's concept. But now you see, most electron negative chlorine will make, most electron positive cesium will make. Generally, the compound between cesium and chlorine, cesium chloride will take. We generally feel that it may be 100% ionic, it may be 100% ionic, but it won't be only 80% ionic. Remaining 20% will be covalent character. Therefore, the partial covalent character of ionic compound, well explained by Pajan, by concept known as what Pajan's concept. By introducing two concepts, based on two concepts, one is polarizing power to the mole. One is polarizing power. Second one is polarizability. What is polarizing power? Many times we use polarizing power. What is polarizing power? Now, polarizing power by equation, ionic charge by ionic radius k. Polarizing power equal to ionic charge by ionic radius k. Might have some actually been given in periodic classification. Periodic classification get in all these concepts. They don't know, leave it. So polarizing power equal to, you can take by equation, ionic charge by ionic radius k. Ionic charge by ionic radius k. But by definition, what is polarizing power? So attraction, the power of cation to attract. Look here first. Suppose you're taking a cation. If they are away from each other, there is no attraction. Whenever they are coming near to a optimum distance, definitely they are having attraction force because they are what are opposite charge. So this particular cation attracts and disturbs. The cation attract or disturb the spherical electron charge density of anion. It pulls near the cation, so that whenever they are coming near to each other, this particular cation is actually disturbing or attracting the spherical electron charge density of anion towards the cation. Anion towards the cation, like this. It may be little attraction, or it may be a strong polarization, a strong attraction. Now, let you see again a cation. Again, anion, electron charge density now much more attracted towards the cation like this. What is actually polarizing power? The power of cation to attract or distort the spherical electron charge density towards itself. Spherical electron charge density towards itself, what we call polarizing power. This is by definition. Equation argument, ionic charge by ionic radius k equal to polarizing power. So this is the definition. Now, this is polarizing power. What is polarizability? Next one. Now, the tendency of anion to undergo to undergo distortion, to undergo distortion of spherical charge density, spherical electron charge density towards the cation, what to call polarizability, tendency of anion to undergo distortion of its spherical electron charge density towards cation, what to call polarizability. Now, what is polarizing power? Second one is what? Polarizability. Next. If polarizing power, polarizability are small. This is small, no? Very little attractive. Polarizing power, polarizability, both are small. Both are small. Resulting bond A will be a ionic bond. Resulting bond A, ionic bond. Now, polarizing power and polarizability. Polarizing power and polarizability. Polarizing power and polarizability, both are large. Both are large. Resulting bond is what? Covalent bond. Resulting bond is what? Covalent bond. Covalent bond. Next. Like this, ionic bond and again covalent bond. Next. Smaller the cation, please. Smaller the cation, right? Greater will be its charge density. Greater will be its charge density. Greater will be its polarizing power. Smaller the cation, greater will be charge density. The spherical charge density is very thick over the smaller cation. So its pulling capacity is more, polarizing power is more. So smaller the cation, greater the charge density, greater the polarizing power. Next. Bigger the anion, look here. Bigger the anion, greater the polarizability. It is not having command over this particular electron charge density. The electron is easily distorted. Therefore, bigger the anion, greater will be polarizability. Polarizability. Based on this particular concepts, polarizing power, polarizability, we will take the Poisson's rules now. Then we enter into Poisson's rules and how to identify a covalent compound, the ionic compound. Let me discuss with you. Come on. Take it. Poisson's concept, you know. The partial covalent character of partial covalent character of ionic compound well explained by Poisson based on two concepts. One, polarizing power. Second, polarizability. Polarizing power, polarizability. Right, next. The power of cation, come on. The power of cation to attract or distort. To attract or distort, D-A-S-T-A-R-T. To attract or distort, D-A-S-T, what it is. Power of cation to attract or distort spherical electron charge density of anion, known as polarizing power. Next, polarizability. The tendency of anion to undergo distortion of its spherical electron charge density. The tendency of anion to undergo distortion of its spherical electron charge density. Electron charge density. Known as polarizability. Next, smaller the cationic size, smaller the cationic size, greater will be charge density, greater will be charge density, charge density, charge density, greater will be polarizing power. Next, bigger the ionic size, ionic size, greater will be polarizability. If polarizing power and polarizability both are small, resulting bond is ionic bond. Next, polarizing power and polarizability, both are large. Resulting bond is covalent bond. Covalent bond. So this cation anion is what ionic bond, covalent bond. So this is what. Three. Take the diagram. Ionic bond, covalent bond. It is very large. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Right. Fajan's rules, come on. Fajan's rules. Second, ionic size is about ionic size. Third, sizes of hydrogen ions. Next, electronic configuration. One exception is the exception also. Discuss it. Exception. Okay. Cationic size. Just now we discussed, well known to you. Smaller the cationic size, greater the polarizing power. greater the tennis to form forehead compound. Look here, suppose I am taking here LI, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Yes, you need to understand. Which is smaller cation? Come on.
Sir, lithium.
Lithium. Smaller cation possesses greater charge density, greater polarizing power. Therefore, order of polarizing power will be lithium is more than sodium, potassium, rubidium. Your order of polarizing power. Suppose I am giving you compounds. Now, suppose I am giving you compound like LiCl, NaCl, ACl, RaCl, cesium chloride. I want to see all of you, which is found to be more covalent? Which is found to be more covalent? Come on.
Lithium chloride.
LiCl.
That's all, LiCl. Lithium is having more smaller size, greater polar. Anode size is same here. So, smaller the cation size, greater the polarity power. Therefore, greater the tendency to form coherent compound. So, what about coherent cation will be? Very simple. This is more than this. This is what the order of coherent character. Order of polarity power, order of coherent character. Very simple. Next, anode size. Look here. F minus, Br minus, I minus. Which is bigger here?
N minus.
N minus.
Is having greater polarizability. Order of polarizability.
I minus.
I minus. Polarizability. Because the anion easily gets polarized. So tendency to distort its charge density toward the cation. So ion I minus is having greater polarizability. Order of polarizability. This is less than this. This is less than this. Is the polarizability. Now, you are given compounds again. Let's see. Come on. LIR. LICR. LIBR, LII. Come on. Among these, which is found to be more covalent?
LII.
That's all. So, all the point that will be this is less than this, this is less than this, this is less than this. This is what a more covalent is what a ionic will take. Ionic. Next. Sizes of either the ions now. Cation and anion both will take sizes. Both sizes will take. Now, when you see carefully, here, Na2O in the world. Then I have MgO. LIF, MgO, AN and U. Carefully look here. Here, F minus. Here, O minus. Here, N minus. Right? Next. Next. Here, LI plus. LI plus. First, you write cation. So that you can understand this. I am writing cation first. Both are taking. Li plus, Mg plus 2, Al plus 3. Are you looking here? Are you looking?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Are you looking this part?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. I am writing F minus, O minus 2, N minus 3. Come on. Answer to my questions. Among Li plus, Mg plus 2, Al plus 3, which is smaller?
Al plus 3.
Al plus 3. A smaller cation is having greater?
Polarizing.
Charge density? Greater?
Polarizing
power. Polarizing power.
Greater polarizing power. Among Li plus, Mg plus 2, Al plus 3, which is having greater polarizing power?
Al plus 3.
Al plus 3. Al plus 3. Good. Come to this one. F minus. O minus 2, N minus 3. Bigger anion?
N minus 3.
N minus 3.
Very good, N minus 3. The bigger anion is having greater?
polarizability.
Polarizability.
Therefore, in which compound you are looking? Greater polarizing power, greater polarizability. Whether in LIF, MG bar, LN. In which option A? Greater polarizing power and greater polarizability. Come on.
LN.
Therefore, LN is?
Larger.
Covalent. Therefore, LN is covalent. So, greater polarizing power is A. N minus is what? Bigger I am. Greater polarizing power, greater polarizability. Both are observed in what compound?
ALN.
Therefore, ALN is what?
Covalent.
Covalent. So, order of covalent cation or BC less than BC less than this. The order of cationic size, order of anionic size. Order of cationic size, this is small, this is bigger than I plus. This is bigger than Mg plus 2, Mg plus 2 bigger than N plus 3. Similarly, F minus order, this is what smaller, this is what O minus is smaller than N minus 3. N plus is smaller, N minus is bigger, higher polarizing power, higher polarizability. Therefore, ALN is what a highly covalent compound. Next. Look here carefully, all of you. In all the three, you are discussed. Either cationic size or the anionic size, both the sizes. One of it you are taking. First case you are taking lithium plus, that is small. Based on that, we are deciding. The second case, I minus is bigger, based on that you decided that LIA is what a more covalent. Either cationic size you are taking or the anionic size you are taking to account, to know the covalent character. Or you are taking both the cationic and in this case you are taking smaller cation, bigger anion, therefore you are taking that is what covalent. So to understand the covalent character, either you have to take cationic size or you have to take anionic size. Are both the sizes. In some compound, what is happening? The cationic size, the anionic size, both the compounds are found to be same. Anionic size, cationic size, both the compounds found to be same. In such case, you cannot decide based on the cationic size, the anionic size. In such case, you have to take the electronic configuration. Are you following? Shall I repeat again? To decide the covalent character, either you have to take the cationic size or the anionic side, or both the sizes, according to your deciding. But in some compounds, some pairs of compounds are having the cationic size is same. In both the compounds, cationic size is same. In both the compounds, anionic size is also same. Then it is very difficult to decide. In such case, you have to take electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. See the word next up, electronic configuration. Look here now. Now we have given two compounds. One is NaCl, second one is PQCl, both. Now, here, Cl is common. Cl minus is common. We did not discuss that one. Well known to all. In both the compounds, Cl minus is there. Then we have to discuss compulsory Na plus and copper plus. This is what a Na plus. This is what a copper plus. Right? Na plus, I only sent you 0.96 angstroms. And copper plus also, surprises you. Size 0.96 angstroms. Then both are having same size, no? Anionic size is same, cationic size is same, then charge is also same, Na plus, copper plus. Then which is having greater polarizability? Which is having greater polarizability is common, but which is having greater polarizing power, deciding is difficult. In such case, we are taking electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. Now, whichever the ion is having, you're following? Whichever the ion is having pseudo noble gas configuration. Come on, Shay, I hope you know what is pseudo noble gas configuration. All of you. You know or don't know?
Don't know, sir.
Pseudo noble gas configuration is 8 electrons in the valence shell. Pseudo noble gas configuration 18 electrons in the valence shell. 18 electrons. The atom or ion which is having 18 electrons in the valence shell, 18 electrons in the valence shell, that is said to be having pseudo noble gas configuration. The ion or atom which which is having pseudo-localized configuration, having what, greater polarizing power. Greater polarizing power. Definitely that forms what a covalent compound. Therefore, you see, I'm writing the configuration of what a copper plus hybrid. Copper plus 28 electrons. Configuration I'm writing, 28 electrons configuration I'm writing. Copper plus 28 electrons. So, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s0, 3d10, 4s0. You've got K shell, you've got L shell. K shell, L shell. You've got M shell. M shell. M shell is there, how many electrons? Come on. 80 electrons. So, whenever the cationic size, anionic size is same, in such case, you have to decide the covalent character, polarizing power, based on pseudo-noble gas configuration. The ionic atom, which is having 80 electrons in the valence shell, is found to be having pseudo-noble gas configuration. The ion will be definitely having greater polarizing power, forms covalent compound. It is well known to you. We need not discuss much. You are given sodium chloride and 2 plus chloride, which is ionic. Hey, Chapadi. Hello?
2 plus chloride.
You are given sodium chloride and copper chloride, which is ionic.
NaCl.
NaCl, that's all. Therefore, NaCl is ionic. We have a greater polarizing power, copper plus 1, therefore copper chloride 2 plus chloride water covalent. Is the ionic, is the water covalent. Easy to understand. Then one more exception is made. The exceptional part is very important. I'll discuss it. Come on, take the rules. Right. Cationic size. Right. Smaller the cationic size, greater will be charge density, greater will be its polarizing power. Greater will be its polarizing power. Polarizing power. Favors the formation of covalent compound. Covalent compound. Take it. Factor of polarizing power. Factor of covalent character. Covalent power, order of covalent character. About ionic size. Okay, this part?
The 1 minute.
No, sir.
Polarizing power, covalent character. Next one, anionic size. Bigger the anionic size, greater will be polarizability. Greater will be the tendency to form covalent compound. Bigger the anionic size, greater will be polarizability. Greater will be the tendency to form covalent compound. To form covalent compound. This one. Under polarizability. Polarizability. Under a covalent character, yes. Next one. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Right. Yeah. Sizes of either the ions. Sizes of either the ions. Right. The cationic size is smaller. Cationic size is smaller. Possesses greater polarizing power. Possesses greater polarizing power. If the anode size is bigger, next point, right? Next point. The anode size is bigger. Anionic size is bigger. Bigger, greater will be its polarizability. Greater will be its polarizability.
So can I repeat?
Bigger the anionic size, greater will be the polarizability. Next, if polarizing power is more. The polarizing power is more, polarizability is more, comma, polarizing power is more, polarizability is more, ability is more, then results in the formation of covalent compound. Results in the formation of covalent compound. Polarizing power is more. What is the ability more? Results in the formation of covalent compound. Take it. Part of covalent character. Order of covalent character. Order of sizes. This also, order of sizes.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Electronic configuration, come on. Electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. Right. In two different compounds, the cationic, and the anionic. Cationic and anionic sizes are same. Cationic, anionic sizes are same. Then the cationic. When the cationic pseudo noble gas configuration, pseudo nucleus configuration.
Sir, can you repeat again?
If two different compounds, cationic and anionic size are same, then the cationic pseudo nucleus configuration. Pseudo nucleus configuration. That is 18 electron in its valence shell. 18 electrons valence shell possesses greater polarizing power. Results the formation of foreign compound. That is NaCl, CuCl. This is what ionic. This is what covalent. Ionic covalent. Copper plus helium.
Yes, sir.
Right. Write a note. The above compounds, copper plus one is having pseudo nucleus configuration. Possesses greater polarizing power. Therefore, CuCl is covalent. CuCl is covalent. Right. Here in the previous example, size of binder ions. Don't write LIF. NAF, right? LIF will write, and that goes wrong. Should be isoelectronic. 10, 10, 10. Therefore, make a correction. Instead of LIF, write NAF. Don't write LIF, make it NAF. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. Don't write LIF, write NAF. Because 10 electrons, Dale crest is much smaller. Exception, you see. What is exception now? Look here. Exception. See the ball. Metal ions. Zinc plus 2. Cadmium plus 2. Xd plus 2. Next time. Sizes. Ionic. sinus. Bionic sinus. 5-6 angstroms. 5-7 angstroms. 5-9-6 angstroms. 9-6 angstroms. Thank you for my knowledge. This particular electron entity is also I am giving. Look here. Electron entity 1.6. Or is it 1.8? It is 1.7 only. 1.7 and 1.9. Suppose, look here. Suppose you are given compound like ZnCl2, CdCl2, HgCl2. HgCl2. Now, think about carefully. Now, Zn plus 2, Cd plus 2, Hg plus 2. The one thing which is bigger?
Hg plus 2.
Mercury.
Hg plus 2. Whether it should have greater quality power or lesser quality power?
Lesser.
Lesser. Bigger the size, smaller the size, greater the charge density, greater the quality power. Therefore, talk to the bottom, what we can understand, quality power is what increasing. Right? Then, zinc chloride, aluminum chloride, and mercury chloride. Come on. Which is found to be covalent among these? Not getting?
HgCl2.
Look here. Look here carefully. Above me, which is bigger said?
Hg plus 2.
Zn plus 2 is smaller. A smaller ion is having greater quality power or lesser quality power?
Greater.
Zn plus 2 is having greater quality according to me and according to you and me according to the discussion. Right? Zn plus 2 is having greater quality power. Then, among these, which should be more covalent?
ZnCl2.
Right. According to our discussion till now, ZnCl2 should act as what highly covalent. Mercury chloride should act as what highly ionic. According to our discussion. But it's completely reverse. ZnCl2 is what more ionic. ZnCl2 is what more ionic, less covalent. CdCl2 and HgCl2. One more I am giving. I explain why. I am giving one more. ZnS. CdS. And HgS. HgS. Come on. Again, zinc, cadmium, mercury. In all these what +2, +2. We call it our discussion. Zn plus 2 is smaller. Its polar power should be more. According to you, according to me, according to our discussion, who should be more covalent among these?
ZnS
should act as what more covalent. But experimental results show that ZnS is what more ionic, is what less covalent than CdS, than HgS. How we explain this? This can be explained based on the concept that top to the bottom, especially in D series, transition series, 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D. 3D is having greater shielding. 3D is having greater shielding effect than 4D, than 4D, than 4F, than 5D, 5D and 4F. It is difficult to understand, try to understand. Now, Zn is having what 3D orbitals, they having 4D orbitals, it is having what? It's 5D and 4F orbital, very clear now. The 5D series comes after Lagrange. 5D series comes after Lagrange. Therefore, once you are moving down the group, Z effective increase. You know what is Z effective?
Effective
nuclear charge on the electrons. What? Z effective. Now, top to the bottom in D series. 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D, the effective, Z effective or effective nuclear charge gradually increase. Why increase? That the low shielding number of electrons increase. Because because 3D is what better shielded than 4D. 4D is what better shielded than 5D and 4F. 5D and 4F. Therefore, 4D, 5D and 4F orbitals are poor shielded. Therefore, the nucleus is actually strongly pulling. Nucleus is strongly pulling the outermost orbital electron itself. Therefore, cation, the anionic charge, the anion is dragged toward the nucleus, strongly dragged toward the nucleus in mercury, in this compound or in this compound. Therefore, once the polarizing power of Hg plus 2 is more because the low shielding number of electrons are increasing from top to the bottom, Z effective is increasing from top to the bottom. Therefore, mercury chloride and mercury sulfide got more covalent, and zinc chloride and zinc sulfide got more ionic. So this cannot be explained based on size, only explained based on increasing effective nuclear charge or the number of electrons, low shielding number of electrons are gradually increasing from top to the bottom. Therefore, ZnCl will got ionic, mercury chloride got covalent. ZnS is what ionic and HCS what are covalent. So this is the actual concept here. The same thing, I want to take down out the table first. Table take it. Electron activity also take.
What is the heading of the first column?
So, metal ion.
Okay.
Metal ion. Ionic size as electronegativity. Order of foreign character. I should take, I give the explanation complete. Clear explanation should be there, otherwise you cannot follow this. Then we go for after this applications. I give some examples so that you know how to say.
Completed, sir.
Completed this also?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now you're right. According to our discussion, top to the bottom, ionic size increasing. Polarizing power should decrease. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Polarizing power should decrease. As a result, mercury chloride or mercury sulfide. Mercury chloride or mercury sulfide could be more ionic. More ionic. In the bracket, less covalent. But experimental results show that. Mercury chloride, mercury sulfide are more covalent. More covalent. more polarized. This can be explained based on increasing Z effective from top to the bottom as low shielding number of electrons increasing. Yeah, other shielding effects. The bracket like 3D is more than 4D. 4D is more than 5D. 5D, whatever. So 3D is more well shielding. Effective nuclear charge is less. But 4D and 5D are less shielding. Effective nuclear charge is more. Color also right. Ionic compound generally white. This ionic therefore white. This is what more covalent, less ionic, yellow. This is what black. Covalent compound is only exhibit color, but not the ionic compound. Therefore, the ionic black, ionic white. This is covalent. Gradually, intensity of the color is also increasing. Covalent character increasing. Colors also right. Red and S, PDS, HGS. Then we see applications. You can easily understand now. You know the entire concept. Simplest way you can understand which is more ionic, which is more covalent. You need not go for all the polarity power, this and that. See. Secondary group halides. Radium. Secondary group chlorides. Because the halides, chlorides. Bd is equal to. See the board. Don't try. See the board. Bd is equal to. Bd is equal to. SRGL2, PSCL. You are given the multiple choice question A, B, C, D, you take. Four are given. Is the following more covalent, is the following more ionic question? It's like that. Very simple. Do not go for size, this and that. You will not go for sign and R. Now, here, what are common? Limit. Then you want to take this particular cation. Right? So, this is what cationic size is what smaller. So which is more covalent here?
BCl2.
So order of current character will be this is more than this. Okay? Without taking the size of the cation and all. Right? Now, you can easily say electronic difference between the bonded atoms. Wherever the electronic difference between the bonded atoms is large, that will be ionic. Wherever the electron difference between the bonded atoms is less, that will be what a covalent. but you should know the electron negativities. Do you know chlorine electron negativity?
Yes, sir.
Electron of chlorine. Don't know. No, I don't know.
No, sir.
No. You should remember few electron negativities once you are completed the period. Periodically completed?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Once you are completing the periodic table, few values you have to compulsory remember for this purpose. Otherwise, you cannot understand the subject. Okay. I'll give the electron negativity a few elements. Try to remember. Come on, what's at least. Beryllium electron activity, right? And gold electron is 3. Beryllium electron activity. It is what 1.2, right? 1.2 is what 3. It's still less. Yes, top of the water electron decrease now. Therefore, magnesium to chlorine, more electrolyte difference. Calcium to chlorine, more electrolyte difference. Calcium to chlorine, more electrolyte difference. And barium to chlorine, still more electrolyte difference. But the electrolyte difference gradually increasing, ionic character increase. Therefore, these units with water, more power. You need not go for size and all. Simply based on electron negativity difference, you really understand. Electrolyte difference between beryllium and Cl is what less, therefore, power. Like that, also can say. We don't go for all the roots and all. Once you remove electron activity, then you can easily make out which is more covalent, which is more ionic. Now, coming to the next one. Hit the board. Calcium RX I'm giving. Hit the board. Calcium RX. Calcium RX. Calcium fluoride. Calcium fluoride. Calcium bromide. Calcium iron. Look here, calcium is common in this, anion is different, anion is different. Come on, among these, which is more covalent?
Calcium iodide.
Calcium iodide, because of size, okay? But without going to this particular size and all, you can easily see. Now, what is the electrolyte of fluorine at least?
Four.
So, fluorine electrolyte is 4. Chlorine electron is 3 and bromine electron is 2.8 and this is about 2.5. These are the electron activity. Now come on, check. Calcium to chlorine electron difference is large. Here, calcium to chlorine electron difference is less. Here, it is still decreasing. Therefore, what? Which is more covalent? Calcium iodide, but more.
Calcium iodide.
You need not go for the size and all. Without looking the size and all, see. Between the bonded atoms, wherever the electron difference is less, that will be covalent. Where the electron difference is large, it will be ionic. Definitely, when the most electronegative, calcium to fluorine electron difference is large, that will be ionic. Calcium to iodine electron difference is less, it is not covalent. Then, the order of covalent character, this is what less than this one, this is what more covalent. One more. And giving third group chlorides, third period chlorides. Third period, NaCl, MgCl2, AlCl3, SiCl2. Come on, SiCl2. Which is more covalent?
NaCl.
Hey! Covalent. Which is more covalent?
SiCl.
Chlorine is common. Sodium to magnesium, magnesium to aluminum, aluminum to silicon, gradually ionic size decreasing. Okay? So this ionic greater polarizing power. Like that you can understand. But take electronegativity. In all these chlorine water, chlorine is what? 3. Sodium 0.9. Magnesium 2.1. This is what? 2.5. This is what? 2.8. Come on, check. In which? Better to chlorine, electron difference is large?
NaCl.
0.9 to 3. And in water? 2.8 to water? 1.8, not 2.8. Number 3. This is what 0.9, this is what 1.3, 1.8. Now, where the electron difference is large?
NaCl.
So, what are the point character? What are the point character? This is less than this, this is less than this, but more power. Coming to the same thing, what I have given just now, except is now, that also we can explain. We did not go for sizes and all. Without taking the sizes and all, we explain. First, you take these three, top, order of point character, order of point character. Electron activities of few elements, remember, few electron activity, few electron affinity, few, not many, all you cannot remember, few compulsory, how to remember for the exam purpose.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Look here, same thing. Zinc chloride, cadmium chloride, mercury chloride, zinc sulfide, thorium sulfide, mercury sulfide. Now, just now we discussed only based on the size, only based on the size of the cation, which should be more ionic, these should be more ionic. But experimental results are showing these are what are less ionic. Out of covalent character, this is what are less than this, this is what is more covalent, less than this, less than this. How to explain without taking the Fajans rules now? Zinc, cadmium and mercury. Electron activity, what have you given this one? 1.6, 1.7, 1.9. 1.6, 1.7, 1.9. This is what electron activity of zinc, cadmium and metal. Come on, check it. What is electron activity for the 3? What electron you want to pay? How about check? In which electron difference is large?
In which electron
difference is large? Zinc chloride. Electron difference what is less? Here also. What electron of sulfur? 2.1, 2.5. How about in which electron difference is large?
Zinc sulfur.
Zinc
sulfur. In this, if the electron difference is large, therefore this is what I am. Electron difference is less, therefore this is what covalent. Easy to understand the covalent character and ionic character without applying the Fajans rules.
I guess there's a power cut.
It's blank for everybody.
Yeah, it's blank for everybody. Okay. I think there's a power cut because even the light has gone there.
Oh, okay.
M. Santosh is the host now. Anyone called, sir?
హలో వినిపిస్తుందా?
ఎస్ సార్.
ఎస్ సార్. ఎస్ సార్.
సార్ నేనే హోస్ట్ సార్, నేను మీకు హోస్ట్ చేస్తున్నాను చూడండి. సార్ హోస్ట్ మీరే సార్ ఇప్పుడు.
ఓకే సార్, లుకింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్? Completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, without taking the finance roles, once you have an electron, it will be a few elements, you can easily make out which is ionic and which is covalent compound in this way, right? NaCl and CuCl, okay? Here is common. Na is electron is very less, carbon electron is more. There will copper particular electron difference less. That is what the covalent, this NaCl would ionic. Easily identify about take mercury chloride and zinc chloride. So mercury electrolyte is large. So mercury to chloride electrolyte difference is less. Mercury chloride is what covalent. Zinc chloride is what ionic. Like that you can take without taking into consideration the Pajan's rule. Pajan's rule we did not consider. Only few points remember. Without taking the Pajan's rule into consideration, we easily make out which is covalent, which is ionic. But provided you should remember few elements, they are electron negative phase. So once you are taking periodic classification, two elements, electron affinities, electron negativities, compulsory how to remember. Otherwise, the remaining part of the subject you cannot easily follow. So, most fundamental lesson is atomic structure, periodic classification, and chemical model. But the three you are thorough, then it will be easy for you the remaining part of the chemistry. Once you are not thorough with the periodic classification, most of the things like this only you won't follow easily. But generally, I never teach chemical bonding directly without teaching periodic classification. But these people are said, teach chemical bonding when I started chemical bonding. It's not the way. Without teaching periodic classification, one should not take the chemical bonding. I never teach chemical bonding without teaching periodic. I have to teach in my own way of the periodic classification. Simply teaching, decreasing, increasing, this won't help you. Won't follow the subject. Not that correct to teach like that. Okay, leave it. What are you doing? Happen to happen. Next, hybridization, okay. Hybridization, next heading. Hybridization. What is hybridization? Let us see. You know very well, intermixing of orbitals of an atom. Look here. I'm taking here one atom. N equal to 5. Calculate 1s2, 2s2, 2p, x1. 2p, x1. Generally, boron valence electrons are 3. Boron always forms 3 bonds. Boron always forms 3 bonds. Therefore, 3 orbitals are required. And only 1 orbital is with 1 electron. 3 orbitals are required. Compulsory electron from s orbital should be shifted to p. Therefore, you cannot, according to this particular, boron has to form only 1 bond. But boron valency 3, third group, compulsory it forms three bonds, not the one bond. Never it forms one bond. It forms always three bonds. Therefore, supply energy. Electron from SR1 is shifted to P. Then in 1s2, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1. This is the case. Excited state configuration. Now, three electrons are there and three bonds it can easily form. Now, what is hybridization? Intermixing of orbitals of an atom. Intermixing of orbitals of an atom. One 2s orbital, two 2p orbitals are intermixed. Intermixing of orbitals of an atom having more or less same energy. Having more or less same energy. There is no much difference in this. Energies 2s and 2p are having more or less identical energy. They will be little different, not the much. More or less having more or less same energy, giving rise to entirely new orbitals. Entirely new orbitals, equal in number and energies. Equal in number and energies. The mixing orbitals. Come on, how many are mixing? Three are mixing. How many are produced? Three. Therefore, again, sp2, three sp2 hybrid orbitals. 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. Hybrid orbitals. In different I got a hybridization. What I said? Come on. Intermixing of orbitals of an atom having more or less same energy producing entirely new orbital. The hybrid orbital not resembling s orbital, not resembling p orbital. Suppose s orbital like this, p orbital is what? Like this. But sp2 hybrid orbital is like this. sp2 hybrid orbital is completely different, like this. This is what sp2. This is what sp2. Right? So entirely new from s orbital and p orbital. So intermixing of orbitals of an atom having more or less same energy, having more or less same energy, giving rise to entirely new orbitals, equal in number to the mixing orbital. Three are mixing, three are produced. Equal in number to the mixing orbitals and also energies. Equal in energies and in number to the mixing orbitals is defined as what? Hybridization. Defined as hybridization. Next. Conditions for hybridization. So, what are the characteristics of hybrid orbitals? What are the characteristics of a hybrid orbital? What are required to undergo hybridization? So now you see, only atoms of one element only undergoes hybridization. Atoms of only one element, not different element. Atoms, orbitals of one atom. Orbitals of one atom only undergo hybridization. Next. The number of hybrid orbitals, produced will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combining. Number of hybrid orbitals produced will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combining. So we are combining, we are produced. Next. The half hybrid orbitals possess equal energies and equal shapes. Equal energies and equal shapes. But all the hybrid orbital need not necessarily, most of them are having equal shapes and equal energies, but need not be necessarily should possess equal shapes. There will be little difference in shapes also. So the hybrid orbital could possess equal energies and identical shapes, but necessarily need not they possess identical shapes. Next. Only orbitals undergo hybridization, not the electrons. Only orbitals undergo hybridization, but not the electrons. So orbitals of the single atom undergo hybridization, first point. Next. The number of hybrid orbitals produced will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combining. All the hybrid orbitals produced possess identical energies, identical shapes. But in the bracket, what we write? But all the hypodiagonals need not be necessarily to possess identical shapes. Most of them may be having same shape, but there is no rule that compulsory they should be equal identical shapes. Next. Only orbitals undergoing hybridization, but not the electrons. But not the electrons. Can you see types of hybridization at all? Discussion. Come on. Hybridization. Intermixing of orbitals of an atom. Orbitals of an atom having more or less same energy, same energy, giving rise to entirely new orbitals equal in number to the mixing orbitals is defined as hybridization. Clear, all of you? Taken?
Yes, sir.
Right. Take this one. Put the brand name 3 and show 3 sp2 hybridorganelles. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Characteristics of hybridorganelles. Characteristics of hybridorganelles. One. Orbitals of only one atom undergo hybridization. Orbitals of only one atom undergo hybridization. Second, the number of hybridorganelles produced will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combining. Number of hybridorganelles produced will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combining. Next. All the hybridorganelles possess identical energies and shapes, but need not necessarily possess identical shapes. Next. Only orbitals undergo hybridization. Only orbitals undergo hybridization, but not the electrons. But not the electrons. But not the electrons. Now under hybridization, we have to discuss types of hybridizations. Right. Types of hybridizations, many are there, many diagrams. Right. So on types of hybridization. First one, sp3 hybridization. sp2 hybridization. sp hybridization. sp3d hybridization. sp3d2 hybridization. sp3d3 hybridization.
Types of hybridization. Okay.
So 1 minute. Completed.
Right. Tomorrow discuss sp3 hybridization, sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. Tomorrow discuss. Any doubt in the plan? Any doubts on it?
No, sir, no doubt.
No, no sir. Doubts.
No doubts, good. Doubt is there? No. Tomorrow I'll continue. Right.